achieve something. You like that? Okay, so what idea you have about the HR thing? I just want to gaze out from your thing. Just recruitment, appraisal, great. Cool. And? Right. So you can check that HR is just not managing the admin part. It involves all the roles of payroll, appraisals, T&D, managing, OD would be part. So I would start with that. How you're going to choose a career path? I've seen that most of you are influenced by your parents, relatives, and everyone. You should go for this opportunity or just go for this program. But I really appreciate that you should follow your heart first. What exactly you're looking at for your career?
How to work? I think. Can anyone help? I think he's looking at that. Oh, I see, man. He's carrying it.
Okay, so college majors are kind of like tattoos. They stay with you forever. What do you understand by this? Yes, because the specialization, what you're going to do with your UGPG programs, it will go with you with your career growth also. If you're going to opt finance, HR, and marketing, it will go along with your career. Okay, I would start with a story. Can you read it? Kuch yaad aaya? Yaad, good. You know two important characters in this? What they want to do and what they have done. Madhavan, I think he was enrolled himself for the IT thing, right? And what he ends up to? Why? Why he went for the photography? Yes. And what about the second character? What he is into? He was not having such sources to get into IT, but he got an opportunity to excel his expertise on that and get into the passion, and he started his own institution in Ladakh. So you have seen that if you have some passion with you, where you want to do something, you should go for that. Rather than, abhi I was just discussing with Deepak that I have seen one advertisement on the TV that jisme kehte hain ki mujhe is institution mein enroll karna hai, main karke sab bhedcha karke ek dusre ke piche bhagne shuru kar jate hain. So I really don't want that you should go according to this. So choose your career wisely. But don't limit yourself lest you limit your options. So how to choose two college majors? You should see your strengths. Everyone has their own strength. Mine is I'm very good in interacting people. Communication is very good with me. So everyone has their own strengths and passion. What are strengths you have? What's your name? Me, yes. Isha, yes. Yeah. Hmm. So, okay. So I can see you are a good influencer also. So I think you are a proper material of HR. So what are you going to opt? That's what I want to know. HR. Why HR? So you want to get into recruitment or what? Training, TND. Okay, so you're going to away from your mother's, what you have, she has started, right? Away from there. Okay. The same I'm going to say that you should not dismiss your interest because everyone has their own expertise. I should say, I'm going to appreciate that you should follow your passion. Now, HR. It's complex also, it's a dynamic also. If I say complex, what do you understand by complex? Cool. Next, anyone want to say about that? You know, I have heard most of from my HR guys, they said HR is a very thankless job. It is? Yes, because you know, most of the time, people, employees, they're after their life, oh, मेरा appraisal नहीं हुआ है, मुझे छुट्टी चाहिए. और वो, end of the day, whatever he's going to do, she's going to do, it is a thankless job. So complexity is that you have to work on the policies, recruitment, admin, operation, and everything. This comes under this complexity. And what about dynamic? Dynamic, okay. What all areas? Okay, so don't you think that HR is just not limited their self to just for the recruitment, selection, and payroll? They have another good, you can say it's a power center of the organization. Okay. Oh, so I'll start with some of the history of the human resource management. You know earlier how HR works? No idea? See, it started in 1920, and what are the basic thing they do? Basically, they are into an admin thing. Just hiring, compensation would be the part of the HR that time. But now, I mean, what they are lacking in? Because they are not working on the employee relationships. They are not working on the organizational growth. So that is the basic thing they are lacking in. That's why they called isolate bankers. So HR is just like just working on the employees thing, that's all the payrolls, hiring, recruitment, all the only part of that. And what makes, what changes made isolate bankers to power centers? क्या changes हमें लाने पड़े 1970 में US companies, what they have done? Because globalization was there. Technology changes with the time because who's going to manage the technology? The human resource, definitely. So what comes? They have to think strategically because if there's the human resource management is poor, they're not going to work on the organization growth because the most part is that HRM is basically works with the growth of the organization also. What do you understand by this? Organization growth. I think you were read about in all your course also. What is organization growth? Sorry? Someone is saying. What do you understand by organization growth? It goes with the technology, strategically planning, working on their policies to get ROI. How are you going to get the ROI? Who's going to get the ROI? Workforce. And who's going to do the workforce? HR. So, HR are the power centers now. Because earlier it was isolate bankers, but now they're working as a power center. They're managing everything, from starting from the organization growth to recruitment, appraisal, training the people. So, they can well versed with the technology and the strategies what's going on in the coming future. So, as I said, that globalization, deregulation, rapid technology change need to become the power center for HR. So, I think you have read that these pressures, what arises? Strategic planning would be there. And who's going to do the strategic planning? HR, because he is going to, he or she is going to manage the human resource, aligning with the various components like the HR people. They don't work with the in-house people. They have other outsourced things also. They have to work with the legal compliances. They have to work with the other vendors to get their work done, right? And to promote the organization effectiveness. Because if your organization is not growing, according to how anyone can survive in the market. So what is HR all about? Developing people. What do you understand by developing people? Yes. How? Yes. Anything? Making align them with the technology, what changes with the industry also. And the second one is inspiring people. How are they going to inspire people? Motivating. How are they going to motivate them? Incentives and right. And time to time they're getting a promotion. Promotion to banta hai na. Promotion nahi hoga to kaise chalega kaam aapka? Aur appraisal bhi tabhi hoga. And then again, I get into the same topic, the pointer, the shaping the future of business. It's not that HR, as an HR, you're working just on the recruitment, payroll, and compensation things. HR is coming as a dynamic role in the industry where you can show your expertise, work like a leader who can change the organization growth. So, shaping the future of business is a part of the HR also. Now, I think you have read all these points in your, in your courses also. Areas of HR: organization development, employee engagement, performance and rewards, employee relations, learning development, HR generalists, recruitment and talent planning. These are not the, all are the pointers. These are the roles what HR do. Earlier it was HR journalist. Are you aware about this term, HR journalist? I'll come to that point also. So earlier, as I said, that HR was just doing the admin part before. But now, if I say OD, employee engagement, performance and reward, employee relation, now these are the roles. And these roles are, they're going to be a part of a organization growth also. So I'll come to the OD first. What OD do? If what OD do? Processes would be there. How things are done. Second, structure, how a business is organized. And third is culture, how people behave in the organization. If I say processes, how things are done, and who's going to do all these processes? Yes. Now, structure. And who's going to create a structure of an organization? HR. So, how you can say HR doesn't play an important role in the organization? It's a backbone of organization. You have to understand, because one can, an organization can wait for sales, marketing people. I know that's a very important component for the growth of the company, but if a power center is not there, who is going to manage all the things? How a company survive, right? Then the culture, how people behave in organization. Who's going to manage this? HR. How he's going to manage? Time to time, they'll do some events for the team management. Yeah, please. Can anyone give me example for that? Team management, how people behave in the organization, culture, how HR maintain the culture in the organization. Right. Huh? Yes. Right. Yes. And what it enters into when everyone is working the same floor, doing events and engaging their self, what ends into? क्या होता है मतलब जब सब इकट्ठे होते हैं तो कैसा लगता है? together. So it's a feel like we are company. Yes, and yes. So a bond create hota hai aapke sab employees ke saath mein, because I've been working with Thomas Cook. So time to time they have the some team management activities also. They do some dandiya nights, they do some activities. So someone has to work on the pot decoration. So it doesn't matter the CA or is the AVP was, everyone was working on the activity. So it gives you a feel of, yes, we are a team. Team management is there. Now, the same I said, employee engagement. If agar ek company mein employees ki aapas mein nahi banti hai, kya hoga phir? And what will be the result? Right. And if this and all these are going to manage by? See, you're answering your own, that how HR is important to manage all the organization things. Again, is HR would be a bridge between the top level management to low level management. It doesn't matter that he is not going to say, I mean, coordinate with the top level to senior level. Now, performance and rewards. What do you understand by performance and rewards? Right, and how are you going to achieve it? And who's going to fix the target? Because, you know, someone can assign you work, but if you're not going to put your efforts in that, you will not get the good performance in that. Right? So, definitely, you have an expertise, but you're not going to show it, and you know, don't have a coordination between your team, so you're not going to get the result out of it. Again, employee relations. If you're not a team, you can't excel. Most of the companies have seen that, अरे उसका appraisal हो जाएगा, मैं उसे खींच लेता हूँ. Most of the corporates I have worked with, I have seen that, एक के सर पे सर पैर रख के चढ़ते हैं, बोलते हैं अरे नहीं, conspiracies. I have seen most of the politics in the big, I mean corporate, giant corporates. But the basic thing, the main role is of HR, how they're going to manage the team there. So they will coordinate with every, if there are grievances with their, कोई problem होता है, तो वो HR ही manage करता है वहाँ पर. Now, HR journalist. I have asked you, what is HR journalist? So, it's the same, they were doing everything. Everything like they start recruiting, yeah. Hi, handle all the aspects of HR. And this model basically work for the small companies. And if I say HR specialist, yes. Now, this would be the role. If you see, I have shown you two roles, not an HR journalist, where you can do everything. From recruitment, training, or finance management, everything you're doing as an HR journalist. But if somehow you have to do some specialization in some course, in some area, sorry, like T&D, I think you have seen that some of the companies, they are hiring people for the training and development. Why so? Why this needs comes into the market? Yes. Right. Okay, so see, this is the individual role of HR. If someone has a good experience, that is, you say that you want to get into a T&D. So T&D again is a part of HR. So you can't apart these roles from HR also. So then recruiter. Recruiter, anyone wants to get into a recruitment? I want to see that. Why so? It's just, why you want to get into recruitment? Right. So, what area you're looking at? Are you just want to go get into some IT or specific or all domains you want to work in? So, you want to work in as a consultancy or you want to get into some big company? It depends upon you because that is your decision. You want to get into work as a recruiter in a consultant, as a consultant, because I'm working as a consultant. Just to give you a brief about me, I'm working for education as a consultant. So my role is to, I place professors, dean, vice chancellor to the all premium institutions. I work for SPGen. ISB is my client, Praxis I'm working with. Great Lakes, I think you heard about that, Great Lakes Institute of Management. Yeah, so I'm working for them. And a part of that, I am working for the e-commerce startups like ChaiPoint, Meesho, and many, many more startups which are based out in Bangalore. Recruitment is always a passion for me. So reading a CV is like doing a detective thing to me. When I open my Naukri and have some requirement from my client, okay, go for a data scientist. I never look at, oh, क्या मिल गया यार मुझे? Oh my God, मैं कहाँ से ढूंढूंगी? वो एक CID का प्रदुमन सिंह वाला नहीं आता, वो फील आ जाता है मेरे अंदर एकदम से, अरे आज तो मैं इसे गया, कुछ तो गड़बड़ है. सो ये जब तक पैशन आपके अंदर में नहीं रहेगा, चाहे वो रिक्रूटमेंट है, चाहे आपका आपका TND है, बिकॉज एवरी टाइम एवरी मंथ द टेक्नोलॉजी इज बीन चेंजिंग, आपके स्किल्स चेंज होते हैं, आज कुछ है कल कुछ है. सो यू हैव टू वर्क ऑन दैट. सो पैशन फॉर योर वर्क हैज टू बी देयर. दैट इज सेड, वी सो हमने निकाला इसमें रिक्रूटमेंट, देन ट्रेनिंग वुड बी देयर. यू नो पेरोल एंड अदर पॉलिसीज के लिए भी यू हैव अ रोल ऑफ HR ऑल्सो. सो पी द दैट रोल वुड बी मैनेजिंग ऑल द HR पॉलिसी. सो दैट इज अगेन अ इंडिविजुअल रोल विद HR. यू डोंट हैव टू बी HR जर्नलिस्ट, यू हैव टू वर्क इन डिफरेंट वर्टिकल्स विद HR ऑल्सो. वाई शुड आई वर्क इन HR? वाई HR? How many want to enroll their self in HR? I just want to see their hands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Most of the girls are two, one boy also. What you, why in HR? I'm asking you, yeah. Is there any particular reason looking at, or as your, anyone has, advised you? Okay. 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 So what is the dif what do you find a difference between a marketing and HR thing? Yes. So the person who have a passion of working with team, with the people, can be a very good HR. So please sit down. So that is more important. If you want to work with the people, HR is the best role for you, so you can go for that. Five reasons to work in HR. I told you HR, what they are into, but if you want to get into a role of HR, these are the five pointers, like work anywhere. You don't have to have a specific domain with you that either you're going to IT, finance, HR is needed everywhere. For the organization development, HR is needed everywhere because they become a power bank for every organization. Variety of work, I've told you, HR is just not limited to the compensation, payrolls, and they are coming into TND, recruitment, policy makings, and other things. So variety of work would be there. If some, because every day when you go to the come do your work, you will get a new work. वो टीडीएस वर्क नहीं रहता है, अरे आज मुझे इतने छापे मारने हैं, मुझे इतना ही आज सेल्स में मुझे टिक करना है, आज इतना मुझे CRM में इतने कॉल करने हैं. द BPOs पीपल दे डू, आज तो 50 कॉल करने हैं. बट इन HR यू विल गेट अ न्यू वर्क एवरी डे. यू हैव अ न्यू वर्क एवरी डे. यू हैव अ नया प्रॉब्लम तुम्हारे सर पे होगा. शर्मा जी आएंगे, मैडम हमारे को तो आज छुट्टी चाहिए. हाँ शर्मा जी ढूंढ लिया हमने, बड़ा इजी सा नाम लगता है ना सब में। आप बता दीजिए, कुछ और बता देते हैं, गुप्ता जी चलेंगे? पवार जी, अच्छा कौन है पवार यहाँ पे? ओहो ठीक है ठीक है, चलो भाई पवार जी को छुट्टी चाहिए, और सर पे सेल्स टारगेट आ गया है मेरे, कौन मैनेज करेगा एचआर? अब किसी को छुट्टी मिल चाहिए और मैनेज करना हो, एचआर कैसे बोलते ना, अरे यार प्लीज, ये यार टारगेट है यार थोड़ा सा। सो दैट इज दैट थिंग हैज़ टू बी इन द एचआर आल्सो, हैव पेशेंस व्हेन यू स्पीक टू एम्प्लॉयज। अगर आप काम कर रहे हैं और आके एकदम से आके कोई झगड़ पड़ता है, तो आप झगड़ेंगे नहीं उससे, आप चाहे अपने रूम में जाएंगे, दरवाज़ा बंद करेंगे, गालियाँ निकालेंगे, सब कुछ करेंगे। बिकॉज आई डू द सेम, जब मैं व्हेन आई गो टू स्पीक टू माय वन ऑफ माय कैंडिडेट, मैं बड़े ध्यान से सुनते हैं, हाँ जी मैडम, लुकिंग फॉर अपॉर्चुनिटी, ओके, पूरा जेडी सुना दिया, डिटेल बता दिया, एंड ऑफ, सॉरी मैम, नॉट लुकिंग फॉर एन अपॉर्चुनिटी। मैं फ़ोन रखने के बाद पता कौन सा गाना गाती हूँ, इसमें तेरा घाटा मेरा कुछ नहीं जाता। तो भाई तुम्हारा घाटा है, तुम्हें मैंने 20 CVs में से तो मैंने एक चूज़ किया, तो मीन दैट यू हैव सम एक्सपर्टीज, सो आदर इज़ अ रिक्रूटमेंट, यू हैव टू बी पेशेंट। आप लड़ नहीं सकते फ़ोन पे उनके साथ, तुम्हें मैंने कॉल किया है, बात सुनो मेरी, सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी पेशेंट व्हेन यू बी इन एज एच आर। मेक अ डिफरेंसेस टू पीपल्स लाइफ, हाउ? बिकॉज सी एज माई पॉइंट, एच आर इज जस्ट नॉट डूइंग ऑल द स्टफ, समहाउ आई यूज टू मैनेज द ग्रीवेंसेज ऑल्सो, आई यूज टू लिसन देम, पर्सनल थिंग्स वुड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ एच आर ऑल्सो। इफ सम एम्प्लॉय केम टू यू एंड आज से परेशान होता है हम, बिकॉज द मोमेंट वी गोइंग टू वर्क इन अ कंपनी, वी अंडरस्टैंड ईच एंड एवरी एम्प्लॉय, आज उसका मुझे मूड खराब लग रहा है, तो वॉट यू डू? आई डू तो कॉल इन कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम, लाइक हैव अ कप ऑफ कॉफी, क्या हुआ भाई बताओ। इफ यू हैव सच क्वालिटी ऑफ लिसनिंग पीपल, हैव अ आई मीन हैव अ एक्सपर्टीज ऑफ सॉल्विंग योर प्रॉब देयर प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन बी एन एच आर, बट यू हैव टू लेंड योर एयर्स टू देम, अदरवाइज आप एक एच आर का मास्क ला के बैठ जाएंगे, तो यू नॉट एबल टू मैनेज ऑल द स्टफ, बिकॉज यू नो यू हैव टू वर्क विद द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स। हे वे चला गया, आपका सब गोल्स खत्म, आपको एमडी आएगा, मैडम सर जी ये लो जाओ, आपका काम हो गया, आप मैनेज ही नहीं कर पा रहे हो कुछ भी। मेक एन इम्पैक्ट ऑन द बिजनेस, अगेन इफ एच आर इज नॉट गुड, यू डोंट हैव अ पेशेंस, यू नो नॉट एबल टू मैनेज ऑल द पीपल हु आर वर्किंग इन द इंडस्ट्री, सो ही कांट इम्पैक्ट ऑन द बिजनेस ग्रोथ ऑल्सो। वॉट स्किल्स डू आई नीड? आई थिंक कुछ तो हमने पहले डिस्कस कर लिया, पर इसके लिए भी, एच आर के लिए भी कुछ चीज़ें तो हमारे इनहेरेंट या एज अ ट्रेनिंग हमारे अंदर भी चाहिए कुछ। क्यूरियस, इंटरेस्टेड अबाउट हाउ द बिजनेस वर्क्स एज वेल एज इट प्रोडक्ट्स सर्विस एंड कस्टमर्स। If you have to be a part of a company, you have to understand the business. If you have a curiosity to understand what business is, if I say an example, take an example of travel, so you have to understand the travel. You have to understand the strength and the weakness of your organization. I think you heard a term of poaching. Poaching क्यों होती है? यस, क्यों की जाती है पोचिंग? यस, और वो पोचिंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के लिए क्यों करते? ताकि हमारी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में ग्रोथ हो। मैं भी करती हूँ, अरे वो अच्छा कर रहा है, गायब कर लो उसे, मैं तो यही यूज़ करती हूँ, गायब कर लो उसे। हाँ, बिकॉज यू नो वी गॉट अ रिक्वायरमेंट फ्रॉम आर क्लाइंट्स एज वेल, दे वर सेइंग यार दिस पर्सन इज डूइंग वेरी गुड इन दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, ओके लेट्स हैव अ वर्ड विद हिम। उसको कैसे खींच के लेकर आना है, किस लिए लाना है भाई? अपनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, फॉर द ओडी, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डेवलपमेंट, अगेन इज अ पार्ट ऑफ एच आर। सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड योर कॉम्पिटिटर्स, यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड योर ग्रो, हाउ यू गोइंग टू ग्रो योर कंपनी, That would be a part of your role, and that you have to very strategic. It's a very dynamic role. Second is digital thinker. Again, it's like gathering and analyzing information to make the right decision. You have all the data with you and you're not able to analyze what has to be used. You can't be an HR. Policies kaise banti hain? Aap kahin se copy cut paste to karenge nahi? It vary from company to company. Aap travel ki company ko data science ki company ke saath nahi laga sakte. So you have to be very analytic with that. So sharpen your expertise, apna dimag tez hona, marketing research dekhna, kya policies jayengi, that you have to work on that. Then again, is a decisive thinker. Second skills you have to have. Skilled influencer. Kaam niklwane kaise nikalwaya jayega bhai? Aaj mujhe report bhejni hai. Aapke manager ka aata hai, yaar mere team mein se 6 log chutti pe maang rahe hain. So who's going to manage it? Not the manager. Manager nahi, yaar they are not listening. Kaisa hiring kiya tumne yahan pe? Wo to he's definitely come to the HR people. So what they going to do? HR? हम तो अचार बोलते हैं हमारे को सब. अचार कोई नहीं बोलता हमें. अचार डाल रखा है हमारा सब में इंडस्ट्री में. सो इन्फ्लुएंस हैज़ टू बी देयर. एक एक हैव सीन वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड नरेश, ही वाज वर्किंग विद थॉमस कुक एज एचआर. सो व्हाट ही यूज्ड टू डू द मोमेंट ही सी एनी एम्प्लॉय दैट ही इज गोइंग आउट ऑफ द वे, चल यार आज तो तेरे साथ ही बैठना है, बहुत दिन से सोच रहा था. सो क्या हुआ इसका, वट विल बी द इफेक्ट? आई थिंक विद डू द सेम थिंग विद आवर फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली ऑल्सो. जब पटाना होता है, मम्मी मुझे मोबाइल चाहिए, ये तो हम घर में भी करते हैं सबके साथ. सो इन्फ्लुएंस, हाउ यू गोइंग टू इन्फ्लुएंस द पीपल इन योर टीम, इन योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दैट वुड बी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस स्किल एंड दैट हैव टू वर्क ऑन. एथिकल इंटेग्रिटी. Guided by a sense of moral fairness and willing to challenge unethical decisions. What do you understand by this? I think you have seen that now organizations are coming out with different legal compliances. Although I have heard that a Posh. Have you heard about Posh? That is for the females. If someone in your organization is misbehaving with you, so you can complain for that. That is a posh thing comes out with an organization. So what has to be there? Most of the maine dekha hai companies mein wahan pe kya karte hain, are female sabse zyada survive kar rahi hai. Most of ne aaj nahi hai. Ya your manager. Your senior manager is harassing you just because of uska mood acha nahi hai. So these are moral things has to be managed by the HR. Now problem solver. Again, ability to work through problems with patience and determination. Problem aa gayi to agar aap thak gaye, are nahi ho main nahi kar paunga, sorry mujhse nahi ho raha, so that will not be an HR. Because every day is is a passion and again a challenge for you. Because the moment you're going to finish that work next day, अरे यार कल तो मुझे ये देखना ही है काम. Because HR, what they do, they plan for everything. It's a people who we're going to work. उनका recruitment plan होता है, उनका finance plan, budgeting plan होता है, meetings plan होता है. If you don't have a expertise of solving problems, you can't be an HR. So you have to be very strategic and very have a ability to work through problems also. What could I earn? कितना कमाना है? 1.5 लाख किसने बोला भाई? अभी से 1.5 लाख नहीं मिलेगा. हाँ, साल का 1.5 लाख. अरे यार ऐसे नहीं, एचआर इतना भी बुरा नहीं है. See, you know, when I started working as a recruiter, my first billing was 40 lakhs. That was my ticketing. So, kamane ke liye koi, and it's an endless thing. You can do that.
40 का 1.2 सीआर कब हो जाता पता नहीं चलता आपको. सो एज अ बिकॉज आई एम बीइंग अ रिक्रूटर तो मैं हमेशा अपने पैशन की बात करूंगी. तो रिक्रूटमेंट में तो इंसेंटिव मैं अपने बॉस को बोलती हूँ, मैं तो सैलरी के लिए काम नहीं करती, मुझे इंसेंटिव दो. योर सैलरी इज जस्ट लाइक योर पॉकेट मनी. ये तो मुझे चाहिए यार, इतना मेरा जिम का खर्चा है, मेरे और खर्चे हैं. बट इफ़ यू अर्न आई मीन ओवर दैट अमंग अबव ऑफ योर सैलरी दैट इज योर क्रीम ऑन योर केक. तो इफ आई से अबाउट द सैलरी विद एच आर, इट वेरीज फ्रॉम कंपनी टू कंपनी बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द कंपनी दे डोंट वर्क ऑन द इंसेंटिव. इफ यू वर्किंग एज अ रिक्रूटर यू विल गेटिंग इंसेंटिव बट देट वुड बी अ सम बोनस पार्ट ओवर दैट. सो अप्रॉक्सीमेटली आई कांट कमिट यू एनी नंबर, इट वुड स्टार्ट बाई 25,000 अबव टू दैट. As assistant, we're going to start with a new company. It would start by 20, but slowly, gradually, definitely, it's going to grow with your career growth also. So HR is a very dynamic role. If you get into this such thing, definitely there would be a good career growth with your things. I want to share a video with you. Hope you like it.
Understanding how to manage human resources will be key to your success as a business leader. Believe it or not, many business people with great business strategies, plans, and products fail because they do not fully grasp the importance of human resource management. Thomas J. Watson, the founder of IBM, said, "You can get capital and erect buildings, but it takes people to build a business." Managers use a lot of words to describe how valuable people are to their organizations. Human resources, human capital, intellectual assets, and talent all imply that people play a vital role in business success. No matter what part of the business you're dealing with, whether it's figuring out where to put a new plant, designing a new product, formulating your strategy, or developing a cost structure, every single business issue ultimately becomes a people issue. At the heart of it, you've got to have people with the right skills, opportunities, and motivation to face those challenges and achieve business success. This is the essence of human resource management, to manage people in a way that drives business success. To drive success, human resource management involves a wide variety of activities, including analyzing a company's competitive environment and designing jobs so the company's strategy can be successfully implemented. This in turn requires selecting the right people, developing their skills to meet strategic objectives, and motivating them toward a common goal. So, if you enjoy bringing people together for a common purpose, coaching and training people to succeed in an organizational setting, and making sure people are properly rewarded and recognized for the work they do, then human resource management may be the career for you. To provide additional insight on whether HR management is the career for you, we've gone out to ask some experienced managers questions about why they chose HR as a career. We got some pretty interesting answers. What do you love about HR?
I love the variety in HR. I am an HR generalist, which means I work in organizational talent, in training, in hiring, in recruiting. I work in organizational structure, helping to reorganize companies and restructure them or bring in companies that are being acquired.
It's actually an interesting field. I had a great mentor once that talked about why he went into the field of OB and HR after doing undergraduate work in finance. And something resonated really well with me. Basically, it said that no matter what business or organizational issue you're dealing with, that could be entering a new market, that could be designing a product, that could be solving some analytical challenge or technical challenge, every single business issue or organizational issue ultimately becomes a people issue. At the heart of it, you've got to have someone with the right skills, capabilities to face that challenge. And so it's how do you find those people? How do you get them into the right roles? How do you motivate them? How do you help manage and unleash their performance? But ultimately, every business issue is a people issue. And the one function, HR and OB, is one that touches every aspect related to people.
There are so many reasons why I love the field of human resources, and it's actually hard to sort of figure it out. And if I go back to what drew me into the field of human resources, it's really sports. I was a big jock in school. I played three sports in high school. I played two in college. And everything I loved about sports, I find, is translatable to the world of organizations, such as organizing to win. Just as if, as when you're on a team and you got to try to figure out what's the right way that we can organize the skills and talents we have to achieve our goal. Same thing is true in an organization. When you're in organization development and human resources, you're getting a chance to figure out how do we assemble the people and the resources and the assets we have to win in the markets that we want to win in, to put the best people in the best roles that amplify their skills and their strengths. And so I found over the years, the more I got into human resources, the more I loved it, because everything I loved about sports is what I loved about human resources.
Why would you want to work in HR?
I knew ever since I was an undergrad that I wanted to go into consulting, and I knew I really wanted to go into consulting around leadership development, executive coaching, organizational behavior, and organizational design, because in my experience, having had jobs through high school and through college, I knew most of the challenges in an organization were with the people. Organizations have figured out how to make products. They haven't figured out how to rally people around a cause.
Of course, HR is a fun and exciting area to work in, but what will you get from studying organizational behavior and human resource management in school? What skills will you develop to help effectively manage people and drive business success? What do I get from studying HR?
I think the advantage is that we've actually been trained with people who have spent time in this field, leaders in this field, thought leaders in the field of human resources, organizational development, organizational design. You have a chance then to put those theories into practice when you go out into the field.
The great thing about OBHR coursework is that it will make anybody in any profession more successful. In fact, we've done a study at General Mills of the things that derail a person's career, and it's usually the OBHR competencies that are the great derailers. So even if I'm planning to be a finance director or a marketing VP, if I learn about the HR skills, communication, collaboration, innovation, understanding the organization, being empathetic and listening to the organization, all those things that HR has kind of an upper hand in, it will make anybody's career more successful.
What is the most useful skill you learn from studying HR?
So for me, it hasn't necessarily been a skill that's been most useful for me in my work. It's been a mindset. And the reason I say that is because the mindset that people have when they're dealing with a talent is that if people aren't doing something right, it's a motivation issue. And, you know, these lazy people, or I have the wrong people in the job. But a lot of times there are mechanisms set up within an organization. So the structure can influence, processes can influence why people aren't successful. But they'll look at people as, you know, shame on them, they're not doing the right thing. But the really, really interesting and fascinating thing, and the mindset I think you have, is to look at an organization as a system and look at how things are influencing that system. Because so many times you'll figure out that it's that system, it's not the individual that's creating the outcome. And if you can change the system, the individual within the system will change as well.
The theory and skills you'll obtain while studying organizational behavior and human resource management are pretty valuable. They'll help you think more holistically, to push against the status quo and question existing assumptions. They'll help you examine organizations as systems and be able to change dysfunctional systems to ensure that people and organizations are aligned towards success. But such competencies are not only important for HR managers, they are vital for all people working in organizations. How do you know if HR is the right career for you?
Probably the test question that annoys me most when I interview people is they want to get into OBHR because they like people. That's helpful, but that's not really what drives the field. It's really the intersection of the strategy the business is taking and your ability to influence that, the degree of effectiveness you have in terms of building systems and processes that enable strategy, and then your ability to translate that in meaningful terms to the broader employee population. That's really the art of OBHR. So if you have an interest in that intersection of strategy, process, and people, that's where it all comes together. So it's much broader than liking people. And again, I've been at enough campuses around the world where a lot of HR people attribute their need to get into HR because they like people. It helps, But that's not a differentiator. The differentiator is to be able to connect strategy, process, systems with people in a very effective, in a very efficient way that drives value in the business.
If you're thinking about it, I would say ask yourself if you are comfortable in both partnership situations and team situations where you can help build on the momentum of a team, but also if you're comfortable in pushing back and dealing with confrontation and interjecting ideas or disagreements in places where it's not as comfortable. If you can be successful in both of those or be comfortable in both those, you'll do great in HR. The other would be business partnership. Are you comfortable not just as a people person, not just as an amiable, but as someone who can, again, understand the whole business and understand how the organizational aspect fits into making an entire business situation become more successful?
Hope you like the video. But I've seen most of them talking. What happened? Boring laga kya? So I just want to know, do you have any questions with you? So we can discuss. Any query you have regarding HR and all? Now after, I mean, discussing all the stuff, how many are going to add now? I've seen 4 to 5 hands up. I see that you to tum to pakka ho, tum to HR. I'm going to see you. I'm going to place you somewhere. So do you have any questions with you and anyone? Nothing? Who says? Who say there's no scope? When I say there are different verticals with HR, how you can say 3 to 4? I think that is with the one organization. If you check every company, there are max to max, you can say 4 to 5 position would be there. It would be talent acquisition, that would be HR assistant, HR admin, HR operations. There are many roles that has to be depend upon you, which field you have to go with HR. It is. If you are thinking over to get into HR, it's a very dynamic role. You will be working as a leader. You don't have to run off the target. Definitely you have some target to place a few employees, because what HR do in a company, they have some planning for the recruitment also. Because how many people they're going to leave by, because someone has some problem of they have to get back to their families, some health issues, they're leaving your company. So you have to keep everything in your mind. How many people you will be looking in the coming years to replace them? There is, definitely there is a goal. You can see me. There is, yes.
Like, I have always a question in my mind. Like, HR requires leadership skills, but how one can enhance his or her leadership skills? Like, if someone has potential,
mm-hmm.
but right now at this point of time, he can't act as a leader.
Mm-hmm.
So how one can enhance his leadership skills? Like, not just leadership skills, but other skills which are required for an HR.
Uh-huh.
Like, how one can enhance these skills, like in other areas like marketing. Like, we can do some work on us to enhance our skills, but how one can do this in
what's your name?
Aman,
see, we have to work on our weakness and strengths also, right? We say the leadership, one has to be go-getter. Like, you have to initiate yourself if some task has to be assigned to you. अगर वो आपके अंदर नहीं होगा, मुझे अरे मैं 4 दिन बाद कर लूँगा. लीडरशिप क्वालिटीज़ कैसे आती हैं आपके अंदर? When you have something in your mind, no, I have to do this. I'll be doing this. This is my task. Then you can drive peoples with you. Otherwise, you can work on your skills, but how long?
Like control yourself and then you control the world.
Definitely. It's a self-discipline, I can say. If you can't control your temper, you can't say anyone. You have to be an example for everyone. अगर मैं पेशेंस नहीं हूँ मैं आपको नहीं बोल पाऊँगी. इफ़ आई एम नॉट अ लीडर आई कैन टेल यू दैट यू हैव यू कैन बी अ लीडर बिकॉज सम हाउ यू हैव टू गो थ्रू सच एक्टिविटीज विद यू बिकॉज यू हैव टू वर्क ऑन योर ओन. मैं कहाँ मेरी वीकनेस है वी नो दैट एंड वी हैव टू वर्क ऑन इट.
लाइक वट काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटीज वन कैन डू टू एनहांस.
Just to give an example, if someone has a problem in speaking in public, he has to start speaking alone while seeing him or herself in mirror. Then start speaking in the groups also. Start group sessions. Because it's make you to speak what you are thinking. जो आप मुझे बता रहे हो that is a personality of introvert, that we live in our own self. If the moment you're going to extrovert, start speaking about you. Putting your things in front of the people, automatically things will work. Okay?
Thank you.
Welcome. Anyone? Yeah? One by one.
Finance people are learning financial modeling. Marketing people are learning the digital marketing. What course as a HR aspirant
HR
we should learn?
HR analyst okay. would be there. And there are many technologies are coming out for the payrolls, commission and other things. You can work on that.
Okay. And ma'am, if we learn some foreign language, will it enhance in our HR career?
That will add it into your skills. If you are looking to settle down your abroad, either you want to work in an MNC where that is needed, because I've seen many Chinese companies, they are now coming to India and they're looking at a person who has knowledge of these languages. That would be added favor in your skills.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, yes, please. Yeah, you know, I face the same at my home, you know. I was discussing with Deepak also earlier that my sister, she's also a global HR. I'm also an HR. I really want to get into marketing and sales. My father was very like, oh, marketing? No, you can't do that. That is not meant for the girls. And I break that rule, you know. I worked as a hardcore marketing sales for almost 4 to 5 years. I have started my own company working as a senior brand manager. It doesn't mean that HR is just meant for the females. And just because of that, I have done marketing sales. I was not in a talking terms with my father for almost 6 months. But you know, it enhances my skills. I have worked on the way he asked me how you can work on your skills. If you were lacking in something, because somehow I was feeling a bit hesitated while talking to people before. But now when I get into marketing sales, you say now you have to run after people the same. So that enhances my skills and that I get into HR. And it's all mindset. That's it. Okay. Kuch hota nahi. HR is a very safe place. How you can say that? A marketing is not a safe for the girls, because most of the in these profiles, the girls are exploited. Why? I'm not agreed over that. I think men can be a very good HR. I have few friends. They are HR and they're doing good. This is all mindset and you have to change it. जैसे वो कहते हैं ना घर का काम सिर्फ लड़कियाँ करेंगी क्यों भाई लड़के भी कर सकते हैं. And most of my friends, they are chefs and they cook so well. मैं उनके पीछे पड़ी रहती यार आज रिसोटो खिला दो मुझे खाना बनाने नहीं आ रहा. Welcome. Yes. Sorry, could you please repeat? I missed something.
First, thank you, ma'am, for enhancing our knowledge on HR.
Thank you.
Right now, we are like in current market situation, there is an industry 4.0, industry fourth revolution. Mm-hmm. Like technology is replacing human being. So how can you say that HR now also has that scope in market?
See, no one can replace human. Can you beat it?
Ma'am, like artificial intelligence.
Artificial intelligence definitely would be there, but no one can replace human. See, if I have to influencing, can machine influence anyone?
No, ma'am, but right now many big industries are opting for technology advancement, which can reduce their labor force and increase their capital in workforce.
That would be repetitive work. See, artificial intelligence thing that would be done where you have a repetitive work. Recruitment, if I say in HR, that would be a different. Today you have to recruit a business analyst. Second day you have to recruit a product manager.
Yeah.
Every time you have to feed the thing. You can't replace a recruiter. Somehow you can work on the software things. Okay, I can manage the data. I can manage the resume data. I can manage all these details. But somehow, man has to be there to manage all the things.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Is there anyone? Okay, I just want to know who, I want to speak to those who don't want to get into HR. Sabhi HR mein jayenge, wow. कौन भाई यहाँ तो सभी एचआर में एनरोल हो रहे हैं दीपक देख लो भाई फिनेंस वाई फिनेंस डोंट लाइक यू इट सीम्स दैट इज नॉट डायनेमिक व्हाई यू से देयर इज नो ग्रोथ वेयर यू हैव सीन दैट यू हर्ड इट बट यू नेवर फेल्ट इट यस Because I always say these HR is a leader. Because all the organization growth, all the things, that is totally depend on the HR. So how you can say that there is no scope with that? See, that is your mindset that you are not want to get into HR things. But you can't say there is no scope in HR. People who are working on such high salaries, are working on 1.2 crores and more than that, they have some place in the organization because they're managing everything. They are a power banker for the organization. If there is no HR in organization, who's going to manage all the stuff? Company can survive without a finance manager for 2-3 months, but without HR, no one can. So there is a lots of scope for the HR. Okay, I think I have to wrap up my conversation with you. Hope you like our discussion. And thank you so much for listening to me. And I had a great time with you. Hope we connect again. Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Good afternoon, students. It's a right, well said quotation. If end is well, then all is well. Going ahead with this positive notion, I would like to thank ma'am. Madam, your incisive analysis will surely have a psychological impact on the minds of the students, specifically for those who are going to take HR as a major. And your insights will surely help them to decide the path they want to choose. So thank you so much for sparing your valuable time and thank you so much for being patient enough. So you can proceed for the lunch. Thank you so much. For attendance, you can contact Madam Bushra.